The testimony did get the attention of everyone inside the courtroom. There was a woman who took the witness stand, and she described an almost identical crime that happened to her. The only difference is she says she got away with her life. That victim, Robin, gave the jury details on a bike ride that she took back in 1990 in Whitehouse. Her testimony today and this police report explain the same crime. Robin told the jury she saw a red pickup truck and then was hit by that pickup truck, knocking her off her bike. And then she says she was grabbed by a man she says was James Worley.
Said, "Get in the truck or I'm going to kill you." And I didn't fight, but I struggled to get away and begged to get away.
Robin remembers fighting off Worley as he tried to handcuff her inside his truck, but she told the jury she escaped out of the driver's side door.
And I saw this man on a motorcycle that was stopped, and I ran up to him and said, "Please help me. This guy's going to kill me." And he just looked at me and wasn't sure what was happening, and I showed him my bike in the ditch, and I showed him the handcuffs that were still attached to my wrist.
The judge told the jury this witness's testimony was not to be used for them to think if Worley did this once, he could do it again. But the testimony should be used only to show the jury this abduction from the past and Sierra's abduction fits the same scheme or design. The case will wrap up this week, and then the jury will begin deliberating on Monday. Once that deliberation does start, they will be sequestered. Today, the jury did receive this memo explaining how they're going to be put up in a hotel. There'll be no radios, no TV. Their phones will be taken and their bags checked, all to make sure that they're not influenced by anyone while they're deliberating and trying to determine if James Worley is guilty or not guilty. Reporting from Fulton County, Michelle Zepeda, WTOL 11.